again, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Horizon Insider. I'm Kyle, and in this episode, we are going to talk about AVC, specifically adding a Spektrum AVC receiver to pretty much any vehicle, and then how to bind it, calibrate it, how to get it set up. All right, now for the sake of the video, I have already removed and installed, well, I should say I removed the receiver cover, make sure you put that back on, and I have installed the Spektrum SRX 6000 receiver down here. Now, one key thing with AVC, the receiver needs to be flat in one direction or vertical in one direction as far as how it's mounted. There's tips on this in the manual that comes with these receivers, but you don't want it to be loose for sure, and you don't want it to be diagonal or crooked in there. So that's the first thing you need to do when you install this. I already have a model created on my DX5 Rugged, so I'm going to go ahead and insert my bind plug now into the bind port. Now, at this point, I like to have my transmitter on and already on the bind screen. That way, when I turn this guy on, this guy is in the vehicle, and I see my orange light begin to flash on the receiver stating that it's looking for a bind, I can immediately go to bind on here, hold the transmitter away, and make that good connection. So I've plugged in my battery. All I really need to do at this point is power it on and go through the binding procedure. So you're gonna see me run through the following steps. Power the vehicle on. The receiver is going to illuminate a pulsing orange strobe. I'm gonna jump over to my transmitter, go in and actually bind the transmitter to the vehicle. At that point, the orange light is gonna remain solid, which means it's bound up, but it is still looking for calibration, which is full throttle, full brake, full right turn, and full left turn in that order. It has to be that order. Each time you give one of these inputs, that light's gonna dim and then re-illuminate, giving you an indication that this has been completed successfully. So you're gonna see me run through this real quick. Take your time, you might have to do it a couple times just to make sure you have it all right, but I'm gonna show you how to check and make sure you did this properly, safely, that's the key here as well, before we even go out and try to use this vehicle. So let's go ahead and power this guy on. Gonna confirm that I do see an orange strobing light on the receiver. And then we're gonna jump over to our transmitter, make sure it's a good distance away from the vehicle. Go ahead and start your binding process. Looks like we're good to go. Okay, so now the lights turn back on. So we need to give it our full throttle input at this time. So I'm gonna go ahead and go full throttle. The light goes off. As soon as I go back to neutral, the light's back on. Now it's looking for full brake. So I'm gonna go full brake, light turns off, comes back on. Let's do full right. Light turns off, comes back on at neutral. Now go full left, light goes off, neutral, it's back on. And you see right there how it just kind of kicked back. Orange light comes back on. At this point, you're ready to go. Pull your bind plug out. Get it out of the way at this point. Otherwise, you're gonna have to redo this whole thing. All right, so we can really quickly check to make sure it received the correct directions. So let's go ahead and pretend like we were driving in the back of the vehicle kicked to the left. This should try to correct to the left, which it does, as you just saw. Same thing if you go to the right, the steering should try to correct to the right. So we're good to go. Now, another key thing I want to bring up is this is completely adjustable. You can turn AVC off, you can crank it up. This is at 50% right now. So I'm going to show you how to do that now. All right, I'm going into my menu. I'm going to scroll down to my AVC setting. And at this point, there might be a inhibit or active switch, or mine actually says on. Make sure that says on. The default values are 50 throttle, 50 steering, and the priority is 100. You shouldn't really have to change the priority too much. This is really more for like the plane side of things where we mess with priority. You need to look at gain. So you can actually go to this gain setting, select it, scroll all the way down to zero, and then just like that, you no longer have that steering correction. Okay, so while we're on the screen, I want to show you one more quick tip that's going to help you a ton when you're out bashing next time. So you're going to see I still have my steering at 0%. I'm going to move over to this setting that says OTF. This stands for on the fly. You can assign a switch, any switch on the exterior of a radio to adjust AVC at any time. So I'm going to go ahead and select this, and I'm going to bump my D trimmer, which is over here. Now, one more thing I need to do is make sure I switch this arrow that says up. I want that to actually be down. So I'm gonna go over to that, switch it down. Now what I can do is, while I'm on the field or on the fly, I can control AVC with this trimmer. So as you see, is my numbers are actually increasing as I'm holding that trimmer up, decreasing as I hold it down. So now I don't even have to go back to this menu to change AVC. So let's go ahead and put this right back up to 50%, which is where it was. And I can show you how this is back on again. Perfect. This is a great thing. Not a lot of people know you can do this. You can assign AVC to any one of these switches on your radio. Makes it much easier, much faster to adjust on the fly. And it's just a cool thing. It's another great thing you can do with Spektrum AVC technology. So we're gonna let you go. Hopefully you enjoyed this edition of Horizon Insider. Make sure if you're watching on YouTube, you subscribe to get a lot more content like this. And if you're on Facebook, just keep doing what you're doing. Let us know in the comments what else you'd like to see. Thanks again, and we will see you next time.